as a personal father. Who is there? Father he is who is not out there somewhere. Father who is always there. Let me share to you another portion of scripture that God said through Jeremiah. And I would say that this love, pag-ibig na walang kapalit. Naranasan niya kung maging gano'n. When you love, and your love was not recruited, you haven't been loved back. Diba? Mahal mo siya, mahal niya ay iba. I love him, but we love another person. So your love was not recruited, or you didn't have the turn back. Usually, I'm going to have an illustration to Pastor Freddy about this. You know how a young man and a young woman fell in love with each other? Usually, in our culture, in Filipino culture, usually, men take the initiative to court. Hindi korte, manligaw. Yeah? They usually take the initiative, they use flowers, they buy chocolates na kinupit sa mga magulang, yung pera pabili. Men usually take the initiative. And look at this. The lady doesn't have a feeling in the beginning. The young lady doesn't have a feeling in the beginning. But because she's being courted, love starts to form. And I learned, and Pastor Freddy said, love begets love. When you start to love, love comes back in return. I have a popular story. My wife, in the beginning, doesn't love me. She wants somebody who is much richer than I am, much handsome than I am. Thank God. And she has some qualification. I'm sure all of the single ladies here have some qualification. The only thing I have is I love Jesus. And I fear God. You know? That's the only thing I can give to her. And she didn't try to love me in the beginning. She wanted to dump me into the garbage. But I'm a persistent man, you know, I wouldn't give up. I said, I want to get married. When I was a pastor in the Philippines, I don't want to get married. The main reason there is I don't have money to support a family. So when I came here, I said, I'm already here in Israel. God brought me here through a miracle. I don't have the money, and God brought me here in Israel. So I said, when I saw Melody, literally my heart said, you're going to marry. And I said, yes, I'm going to marry that girl. I'm talking about Melody. And Melody in the beginning doesn't love me that much. But I always go to Malcolm with her, you know? I always go to mall with her and visit her. I still, you know, I would like to go with her even though I don't like to go there checking up on clothes. It's not for men to look for clothes. And I just come, I enjoy her company. And we together, she usually pays. Sometimes I do. And listen to this. I told you love begets love. In the end, she loved me.
Amen.
And I have two children now.
Said prayer.
One 6 years old and one 4 months old, 5 months old. And look at this, the script of the Father towards Israel. How I will set you among my sons and give you a pleasant land, a heritage most beautiful of all nations. Talking about the land. And I thought, you would call me Abba Shilim or Abib.
Nepod.
I thought you would call me my father
and would not turn from following. It seems the father here is looking towards Israel and said, you know, I place you in a beautiful land. I give you a heritage. So what I did to you, your response will be, you call me Abba Shili. El means that Rohi, Roeh. Not Rohi, Yakaleh. Maze shepherd in Hebrew.
Shepherd?
Roeh. No, but in Greek.
Completeness, perfectness, everything.
said in the Hebrew concept when they say shalom, that means may you have everything that you needed in this life.
So when you say magia lang shalom, bersin lang shalom, you are giving a blessing of completeness of blessings.
El Olam. Now you know the word of Olam has three translations.
Yakala, you know the three translations of Olam.
Universe. Help me in my preaching. Maon. Leolam. Eternity. Maon lahat.
Balik ko ito sa'ya, Ulban.
It's universe, it's eternity, and I have another one. El Olam. For everything. God of all the world.
Zeh
gamakom. Hashem gam zeh makom. But universe is the same as world. And you have three meanings of Olam. Eternity, universal, and I think the third one is places. All of the places that you can find. Now, God of all the universe. God of all the worlds. You know, Father, now that is your Father. He's not confined in a very place called heaven. Even the book of Solomon, even Solomon, when he prayed, he said, the heaven of heavens cannot contain you. When I was in the Bible school, there is one question that a philosopher used, and he asked a question to our teacher. He said, sir, you said God created the heavens and the earth. And you said God lives in heaven. I have a question. Because he wants to demonstrate his love towards them. Next. God has a problem. The Father has a problem. His creation, his children, isn't this? He's supposed to love him, but they rebelled against him. Adam and Eve started the rebellion, and all of their children have been rebelling against God since that time, since the creation. So God has a problem, and God has found, the Father has found an answer to his own problem. The Father sent his only begotten Son and sacrificed him for the payment of sins of this people who we would like to call children. Hello, first off,
John 3:16.
I changed the word. But exactly what it means. The Father loves the world so much so that he sacrificed his only Son. Anyone who believes in the Son will not perish, but have a long-lasting life. Let me give you the nature of the Father. I have here some Hebrew words. The name of God in Hebrew is Elohim. Actually, that's the plural of El. When you say El, it's singular. When you say Elohim, it's plural. Say that one? Okay. Yad is singular. Yadayim is plural. Ben is singular. Bamin is plural. When you put I am, somehow you change the singular into plural. What else? Sefer. Sefer in Hebrew. Sefarim, if you make it plural. So God, his name is plural. God is not a singular God. His name is Elohim. Breshit bara Elohim. In the beginning, God created. Now, these are his name.